Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today's video is going to be my beauty favourites. So it's going to be makeup and skincare. Just a few things that I purchased recently that I've tried out and I'm absolutely in love with. And just thought I would share them with you. So let's get started. So first I am going to do skincare with you. Skincare for me wasn't actually something very important a while ago. I have a few problems with my skin. I'm so fair that, you know, I do sometimes get a bit of sun damage because I don't even think about putting sunscreen on my face. I used to just wash my face with a face cloth or a face wipe, and that was it. I wouldn't do anything else with it. But since watching a few YouTube videos and realising that I actually need to do more to my skin, my skin has been amazing. I mean, I know I've got a little scab here, but that was a blemish that came out, and just like either the dogs kept scratching me and it kept coming off, or I've accidentally caught it, or me being naughty and I've picked it a little bit. Guilty. That's the only thing I've got currently, but apart from that, my skin has actually been really, really good, and this is all down to my recent skincare routine, so I thought I would share that with you. So a few things that I've been loving at the moment is, so if I do use a face wipe, I use two. I use the Nivea Daily Essentials 3-in-1 Gentle Cleansing Wipes for face, eyes and lips. Now I use these because it says it's for dry skin, but it's also sensitive. Now I do have really sensitive skin and I do have dry skin as well, so I absolutely love using these when I do want to use a face wipe. I also love the simple ones. I normally just use the Kind to Skin moisturizing wipes, but I ran out of those lately and I saw these ones, and these are the exfoliating face wipes with double-sided cleansing and exfoliating action. So just, you know, if I do need to get a bit of the dead skin off, I can use these. So one side exfoliates and then the other side cleanses. Really, really liking these. Sometimes if I don't have that much makeup on, I will just go over this first before I use the rest of my cleansing things. Simple is just really, really good because it's so sensitive. And I love that it's for really sensitive skin, and I love that. My skin absolutely loves it. So yeah, I will use these, and then I also have the Simple Kind to Skin Micellar Cleansing Water. As you can see, I've used a bit of it. I absolutely love this stuff. Again, my skin absolutely loves Simple products. I've never broken out with Simple products. I actually also have an under eye roll-on that sort of stops the puffiness and wakes you up. It's actually in the bathroom. I forgot to go and get it, but that is also a product I would recommend for my morning routine. It's got 3 vitamins, 2 skin loving ingredients and 0 artificial perfume or color. I really, really recommend this stuff. I haven't actually been using this lately just because I have found Bioderma. This is my holy grail for taking off my makeup. I absolutely love this stuff. I still use this as well. If this is somewhere else and I can't find it or I can't be bothered to go and find it, I will use this because it's right next to my bed. And I love absolutely both of them. So yeah, this is the Bioderma. I got this in the 250ml. I think I got this from, is it Amazon or eBay? I think it was Amazon. I absolutely love this stuff. It is so, so good. I'm planning on taking some with me on the flight to New York, just in case. I'm not planning on wearing any makeup on the flight. I will just put some moisturiser on, my tinted moisturiser, probably my Laura Mercier one. But if I do, because obviously it's like an 8-hour flight, if I do want to take anything off my face, then I will be taking this with me so that I can take it off. But I would highly, 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 highly recommend this stuff. It is my holy grail stuff. I absolutely love it. And it's not actually that expensive. I thought it would be really expensive, but it's not. Really good. So after I have done that, I then like to tone. And I am actually using the Pixi Glow Tonic. I saw a review on this and everybody was using it. I think it was first Zoella who said that she was using it and she absolutely loved it. because it's got 5% glycolic acid in aloe vera and ginseng. I have another Pixi product as well, but I am currently waiting to go and get the double cleanse. I'm really excited to go and get that double cleanse. But for now, I just have these two. And I absolutely love this stuff. It smells amazing. I just got that on my lip. No, you're not supposed to drink it. smells amazing. It does sort of dry out my skin a little bit, just because obviously I've cleansed and then I tone, and it does dry it out a little bit, but I like that, to know that everything has been taken off my face. So I would highly recommend this. I've just got this in the little travel size. This is the 100ml. When this runs out, I think this will probably run out before I go to New York. I will purchase another one, whether it be a full one or another little one just to take in my carry-on, I'm not sure, but I will be purchasing another one anyway. So once that's dried out my skin, I will then go in with my Clinique Moisture Surge Extended Thirst Relief. Now, I have two. They're only the little ones. These are the 15ml, I think. Where do you say that you are? Yeah, 15ml. I have two, just because I think it's this one. Yeah, I've used it so much, it's about to run out. But you really do only need the tiniest amount, so I did repurchase it. And I think I've got these off Amazon again for like £10. The only thing with this one is, and I'm not sure whether I'll be purchasing it from Amazon again, is it came half full, which I'm not really happy about, because it is a really good product and I expect when I purchase things for it to be full, not half full. So yeah, but I would really recommend it. I was never really into Clinique. I don't know, I never really saw the hype about it, and I thought I would test it and see, and this is like my second holy grail product. I will not go anywhere without this now. So as soon as I wake up, I will clean my face with my Bioderma. And then I may tone, I may not, depending on how I feel that morning, but I will always put on my Moisture Surge. I absolutely love this, just to get that moisture back into my skin. Obviously, my Tonic has dried out my skin. I need something to put that moisture back in. And this does exactly that, and I absolutely love this. I would recommend this to anybody. Please, if you have dry skin, you need this in your life. And then my last thing for my beauty routine of a night, I use the Pixi Beauty Sleep Cream. I absolutely love this stuff. This I really, really like. I just love this stuff. It is just amazing. Put this on at the end and the smell of it just makes me so relaxed and just fall asleep and just drift off to a natural sleep. And then it also just makes my skin feel so soft and just beautiful in the morning. I absolutely love this stuff. It's really, really good. And then the last thing for my beauty, throwing it on the floor, is the Body Shop Almond Milk and Honey Soothing and Restoring Body Lotion for sensitive and dry skin. I really, really like this stuff. It is really, really good. I use this all over. And it just makes my skin feel absolutely amazing. And it's not actually that expensive. I think this is about £8-9, I think. I can't actually remember. But yeah, I highly recommend this stuff. It's the best body lotion that I have. Now, I have really, really dry skin. Worse on my legs and my arms than I do on my face. And this stuff just stops me from itching or anything. And I just highly, highly recommend this stuff. It is really, really good. I really like it. Worth the money. Okay, so that was all my beauty and skincare type of stuff. Now I am going to move on to my favourite, absolute favourite makeup products. So, first thing I will do if I have just done all that and I just want to sort of refresh my face a little bit, I will use my MAC Prep and Prime. What is going on today? Fix Plus. Now I will just give it like two squirts on my face just to freshen it up. Go as you do, you look like a Wally. Just to try and dry it out a little bit, because sometimes No, not sometimes. Most of the time, I'm usually in a rush. So I don't have time to be sitting there and waiting for my face to dry. So I will use that. Love it. I've got the little sample size just because I wasn't sure whether I actually wanted the big size. But I love this. I will be repurchasing this in the big size. So use that. And then, if it depends... Right, I'll show you two products. They're both from Laura Mercier. Is it Mercier or Mercier? I'm not really sure. Whoops. Oh my goodness me. I don't know what's going on today. I can't speak and I'm dropping everything. So... if I want to have a no makeup makeup look, I will use the Laura Mercier Tinted Moisturiser Oil-Free SPF 20 Hydration Tint, which looks like this. I absolutely love this stuff. And then I will carry on with the rest of my makeup. But if I do want to put foundation on, then I will use my Laura Mercier Foundation Primer, the Hydrating one. Obviously for my dry skin, so I will use this, and I absolutely love this stuff. They both smell really, really nice. I actually really like it. Laura Mercier stuff, I don't know, there's just something about their products that I've just fallen in love with. As you'll see by this video, I've got like 6 or 7 of their products. It is just absolutely amazing. So I will use that as my primer. Foundation wise, I haven't really found a foundation that I am absolutely in love with and I can't live without. I have my Urban Decay Naked Skin, which I like, but sometimes makes me look a bit too pale. Even when I've bronzed and blushed and done everything to try and warm up my face, it still makes me feel really, really pale. But I still really, really like it at the same time. My NARS All Day Weightless Luminous or Luminous Weightless, I don't know, that one anyway, foundation, I do absolutely love as well, but I haven't been wearing as much recently just because, again, I'm not really sure about it. I have to give it more time. I've only had it for about 2 weeks, so I do need to give it a bit more time. The foundation that I have been using the last 2 days, only because it is one that I have just purchased, and I'm actually really enjoying using, is the e.l.f. Moisturising Foundation Stick, which just looks like this, and you just wind it up and there comes the product. And I've actually really been liking this. This is what I've got on my face at the moment. I don't know, there's just something about it. I really, really like it. It just makes me feel like I don't have makeup on, but it glides on so easily, it blends out so easily. It's the perfect shade for me. I've got mine in ivory, and it's just so buildable. Like, if you want high coverage, you can do one layer, let it sit for a little bit, put another layer on, and you've got full coverage straight away. You can use it as a concealer as well. It's just absolutely amazing. I really, really like it. Yeah, I don't really know what else to say about it. I just really, really like it. Good find. I've only just recently purchased this, but I really like it. So once I've done that, the concealer that I've actually really been liking at the moment, let me just try and find it, is my Maybelline Fit Me in 15. Now, I've got the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer as well with the foundation, and I've also got the Collection Illuminating Touch Under Eye Brightener, and I've also got the Collection Concealer one as well. I actually prefer the drugstore brands to the high-end brand. I don't know. I really like the Urban Decay one. I do. It is really nice. But for every day, I've just been using my Maybelline Fit Me with the Collection Under Eye Brightener. I really like these two. And I think I got this one from Morrisons for like £3, something like that, and obviously this was like £2, so £5 for both of them, and I spent £19 on my Urban Decay one. I'd rather go for the cheap stuff. Yeah, would recommend them actually, and together they're really good, but separately they're both just as good, but I do like them together. So that's them. Once I have done that, I then like to set my face. I am going to try and invest in a Laura Mercier setting powder to set my face, or a Bare Minerals one, I think. But currently I have been using the Rimmel Stay Matte Long Lasting Pressed Powder, and I've just been using it in transparent. I did have this one in silky beige, but it took me a while to realise that it was actually sort of making my under eye look a bit discoloured, because it is a darker shade to what I would normally wear. But this one's obviously transparent and I really, really like it. It's a really, really good drugstore brand. This again was something like £3 from ASDA. But yeah, a really, really good one. I really, really like this, so I would recommend this one as well. Then if I wanted to set my face, I would normally go for my Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. It's actually, I'm falling off the bed, it is actually in my makeup collection drawers at the moment. I would recommend that one, it is really good, but I have actually been using the NYX Studio photogenic finishing powder. It looks like this, and it is just a translucent powder. Try and show you without it tipping all over the place. So the product just comes in there. The only thing with this is it is so much more loose and powdery than my Laura Mercier one. So I tried to use this morning, and as I put it on my brush and put it on my face, I'm wearing black leggings at the moment and my leggings turn white. And that doesn't happen with the Laura Mercier one, because it is just a bit more of a thicker consistency, which I do like. I do like this powder for the way it sets my face. I would just have to have something covering my legs or do it standing up, because it does really go everywhere. This was only £8, I think. I can't remember, but I would recommend it. It's really, really good. If you do want a drugstore translucent powder, I would recommend NYX, because it is really, really good. I would go in with a bit of bronzer. Now, I currently have two favourite bronzers. I have just purchased a new Laura Mercier bronzer and highlight, which I haven't tested out yet, but I'm sure they are going to be one of my favourites. But these are the ones that I have been using recently and I wanted to share with you. I have, of course, Benefit Hoola bronzer, box bronzer. I've just got the mini version just because I did want to test it out, and I absolutely love this stuff. It is really, really good. It gives me a nice sun-kissed glow to my face because I am so pale. Sometimes bronzers make me look muddy and ashy. And just like I've literally painted a bit of dirt on my face, but this just gives me that nice glow. At the same time, so does the Urban Decay Beached Bronzer in Sunkissed. I love the packaging of this, it's just so pretty. So that's that one, the Urban Decay one, and the Hoola Bronzer one. Let me just grab them side by side. They do obviously have different tones to them. This one is a little bit more warmer and this one is a bit more cool toned. But I do actually like, I like them on their own separately, and I actually like using them together as well. I think it just really brightens up my face. And I would recommend both of them, to be honest. And then I would go in with a bit of blush. Now, the blush that I have been loving at the moment is the NYX Intuition blush that looks like this. And I'm just loving the drugstore stuff just a little bit better than the high-end stuff. The only other blush I would recommend at the moment is my Zoeva blush that I really, really like. Again, that is hidden away somewhere in my makeup drawer. But I haven't been reaching for that as much as I have been reaching for this. Now, this is what it looks like, and it is just a beautiful colour. Let me just look at that. That is just amazing. I just think that is just, and with my bronzer as well, I just think that is such a beautiful colour. And this was only £6 as well, so I would recommend this. Again, this is in the colour Intuition. I am going to have all of these products listed below, so do not worry if you don't remember what any of the names are. I'm going to list them all in the description box for you in case you want to go and purchase them, and also where I purchased them as well. So the next thing that I would recommend is actually a beauty tool, and it is my beauty blender. Now, I have been in love with using brushes at the moment, and I can't really recommend any of my brushes to you, because I've talked about them so often. And if you want to go and see my everyday brushes, they are in a previous video, which I will try and link down below for you as well if you do want to go and see it. These are just all of my everyday brushes. It is in my makeup, my brush collection video, so if you want to go and see them, please do. But I have absolutely been loving my beauty blender. I do apologize, it's dirty, I used it this morning. I do need to go and wash this. I actually have another one coming on the way with the two little mini ones as well, which I ordered. I'm waiting for that to come. But for blending in my concealer, I absolutely love this. This is the only thing that I use it for. I don't actually like using it to buff in tinted moisturiser or foundation or anything like that. I haven't tried it, but I'm not really a sponge person. I used to be. I used to apply everything with a sponge. And I just don't think it gives the same flawless look that a brush does. But I also think that a brush doesn't give the best look for a concealer than a sponge does. So I like to mix and match. And I use a sponge to blend in my concealer and then to bake as well with my powder. If I fancy baking that day. But yeah, I would recommend getting a beauty blender just to have to your collection, only because it has the point and it can really get in to that inner corner of your eye to blend in your concealer, and I just absolutely love it. I think the last thing is highlight, actually, and the highlight I have been enjoying wearing is my Bare Minerals Invisible Glow Fair to Light. Now you will see in one of my recent videos, this sometimes just doesn't give me the payoff that I want unless I apply Fix Plus to my brush and then dip my brush into the product and then apply it to my face. But when I do, it just gives me the best glow. I'm actually wearing it on my face today. I don't know whether the camera will actually pick it up, because I have been out trying bronzers and things like that, so I do actually have bronzer on my face as well. But this is what it looks like. Looks like this. I featured this in a few of my recent videos just because I do really, really like it. I need to give it a bit more time to love it, but I do like it. And I would recommend, if you are fair like me, it does give you a really nice shine to your cheeks, especially down the bridge of your nose and on your cupid's bow as well. It really does. It's just on point for that. I really do like it. So if you're looking for a new highlighter, I would recommend this as well. I would also recommend, let me try to find the right one. This is it. The Laura Mercier Highlight 01 as well. This is what it looks like. I just love the packaging of these things. It's just so beautiful. I really do like it. And this is, I love the fact that it comes with big mirror as well as my Bare Minerals and my Urban Decay. I love that. And this is what this looks like. I absolutely love, love, love this. It is just amazing. Look at that. That is just, I can't even get like the right angle of my hand to show you, but look at that sheen. It is just amazing. I really, really like it. I would just recommend this to anybody, as well as the matching bronzer as well. Only worn that once, the bronzer so far, but I would recommend it because it is really, really good. It is Laura Mercier, of course, it's going to be really good. I got mine in bronze 02. That's what this looks like. I'm just going to swatch that for you. Now that is that. And I just think, I have put quite a bit on my hand, but I just think that is just absolutely stunning. They're both matte products, so they are buildable as well. Again, this one comes with a mirror. Laura Mercier for me is just a top-notch brand. I just absolutely love her stuff. I would recommend that to anyone. I would recommend Bare Minerals to anybody. I would recommend NYX as well, and Maybelline as well, because I just think those are just absolutely amazing products. There is one product that I want to talk to you about. It's sort of like a hit and miss for me at the moment, and this is the NYX Matte Bronzer. Now, I purchased this a few days ago, and I'm not sure about it, to be honest. If you've used this product and you're fair like me, I have mine in the shade Light 01. Could you please leave me a comment and let me know how this works for you? Because I'm not sure about it. This leaves me looking a bit dirty, and who wants to go out looking dirty? And I only use a small amount. I tried putting it on my face this morning. At the moment, like I said, I've been out testing other bronzers. So the bronzer that I have that you can probably see at the moment is not actually this one. It is one that I'm testing. But I do have this on underneath and sort of all over my forehead and my jawline. I don't know whether you can see, but I don't know. I don't know how I feel about this. I think you have to have it for a while and use it for a while to be able to be able to determine whether you like a product or not. So I will let you know on this front, to be honest. If you want me to do a one brand tutorial, because I do have a few NYX products, I am also going to go and get the NYX foundation stick as well. So if you want me to do that, then please let me know in the comments below, and I will let you know how I feel about it with the other NYX products as well. If you would also like me to do a one brand tutorial of Laura Mercier stuff, then please let me know, because I would really like to do that. I may just do that anyway. But yeah, let me know what you think about this one, because I'm not sure, I'm not sold. But anyway, guys, that is all of my favourite beauty products, skincare and makeup at the moment. Don't think there's anything else apart from when I'm finished with my highlights, I would just spray some more Fix Plus just to set my face to make sure it's not going anywhere, because who wants their face to go anywhere? Yeah, would recommend this stuff, it's really, really good. So, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Please like, please message me in the comments if there is any products in there that you would like to purchase. Yeah, and just please subscribe to my channel, because I will be doing many, many more videos. I will try and get the one brand tutorials out as well, because I really, really want to do them. If there is any products that you would like me to review, please let me know in the comments as well, because I will love to do that. And I hope you all have a beautiful day. Thank you so much for watching. Bye, guys. Hi, guys. Just a little add-on. I forgot that when I was just doing my... Just pardon the dog on the bed. When I was doing my beauty favourites for my makeup, I left out my eye palette. How can I forget that? Oh, my goodness. So, I'm doing this on my vlog camera, so I'm just going to turn you around. Just have the sweet... Oh. Hello! I have the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. I absolutely love this. It smells of peaches. It smells absolutely amazing. And I love all of these colours. I would absolutely recommend this palette. I love using... what's that one called? Is that Georgia? Yeah, I would go in with Georgia. And then I would normally go in with Luscious. Sometimes I will go in with just peach or candid peach. I absolutely love that. And then I absolutely love Bellini, I think it is. I also love Summer Yum. I don't know what Summer was. Summer Yum. Apologies for it being dusty. Like I said, I have just used it. I also love Peach Pit as well. I just love all of these colours. They are just really nice. And I also love Cobblet as well. So yeah, so I would absolutely recommend this palette. I love it to pieces. And yeah, I just love the packaging as well, and I just love how it smells. It smells amazing. So that was everything, guys. Please subscribe again. Don't mind the dogs fighting on the bed, because that's just what they do. They're obviously trying to get attention. Frankie, what are you doing? It's Frankie and Aussie. Frankie, say hello. Say hello, buddy. He's so pretty, isn't he? Hey, you're so pretty. Yeah, hi buddy. He's my baby. And then there's Aussie. This is my other baby. They are my loves. And you, you beautiful boys. Love them to pieces. Hello. Hello, what you doing? They just love attention. So thanks for watching, guys. Have a beautiful day. Bye.